We want to solve the following linear equation in one variable. In the bottom of the screen in red, we do have some guidelines for solving multi-step linear equations in one variable. The main thing to remember is when solving a linear equation, the goal is to isolate the variable on one side of the equation. So there's really two ways that we can approach this equation. We can solve this in its current form, or we could try to eliminate the fractions right away and then solve the equation. So I'm actually going to show two methods for solving this equation. In the first method, we'll go ahead and just isolate the variable x on the left side. So we have 2/3 x, which means 2/3 times x, minus 2 equals positive 4. So to isolate the variable x on the left side, we have to undo this multiplication and undo this subtraction. And we always want to undo the addition or subtraction first before we undo any multiplication or division. And the opposite of minus 2 is plus 2, so we'll add 2 to both sides of the equation. So we have 2/3 x minus 2 plus 2, that would be 0, that's why we did that, equals 4 plus 2 is equal to 6. Now remember, our goal is to have x equals some number. And since these are connected by multiplication, we might be thinking we should divide by 2/3. Remember, dividing by 2/3 is the same as multiplying by the reciprocal. So instead of dividing by 2/3, we're going to multiply both sides by the reciprocal of 3/2. Let's go ahead and put this 6 over 1. When multiplying reciprocals, the product is always 1. Notice how these 3 simplify out and these 2 simplify out, leaving us with 1x, or just x. And then on the right side, we have 3/2 times 6. But notice that 6 and 2 share a common factor of 2. There's 1, 2, and 2, and 3 2s and 6. So we're left with 3 times 3, which is 9, all over 1. So x equals 9. Now the second method of solving this would be to clear the fractions in the first step and then solve the resulting equation. And since we have a denominator of 3, if we multiplied every term by 3, we would clear the fractions. Let's go ahead and try that. Again, because we have a denominator of 3, we're going to multiply every term by 3. And as long as we do the same thing to both sides of the equation, we maintain equality. So looking at this first product, this is 3 over 1. Notice how the 3's simplify out. So we're left with 2x minus 3 times 2 would be 6 equals 3 times 4, which is 12. So the solution of this equation should be the same as the solution we had on the left. So to undo the minus 6, we would add 6 to both sides of the equation. Minus 6 plus 6, that would be 0, that's why we did that. So we have 2x equals, this would be 18. And again, since 2x means 2 times x, to isolate x, we'll have to divide both sides by 2. 2 divided by 2 is equal to 1, 1 times x is x, and 18 divided by 2 is equal to 9. So notice how whether we work with the fractions when solving the equation, or we clear the fractions to begin with, the solution is the same. I hope you found this helpful.